A lot of people I've spoken with say that they haven't gone scuba diving for one reason or another. Time, money. There are scary things that lurk in the deep, dark ocean. All are completely valid, but if you also want to experience a dive in Mexico with me, then let's do this. From learning to traveling adventures, subscribe to my channel and don't forget to hit the little bell icon to be notified when I upload a video every Wednesday. Hi friend, I recently went diving at a dive shop in Mexico called Discover Manzanillo. I was in Mexico visiting family for our family reunion, which hasn't happened in years. And we stayed at a place called Las Hadas by Brisas. It was a resort that had all kinds of amenities. One of the amenities at the hotel was this hut that was located on the beach. They had kayaks and paddle boards, and they also had this flag that indicates that scuba diving could be had here. So I went to the hut, got to practice some Spanish to book a dive, but I wasn't actually booking the dive with the resort or any of the amenities within the resort. The resort worked with this dive shop called Discover Manzanillo. If you're interested in booking a dive, I highly recommend you contacting Discover Manzanillo directly instead of going through one of the resorts that they work with. Because if you work with a dive shop directly, Mariano will be able to recommend to you which days will be less choppy, which days will have clearer water, and if you have any certification questions, he'll be able to answer all of that. Comment below and tell me if you have ever gone scuba diving and why or why not. I'll go first. I wouldn't want to go scuba diving because of sharks, but actually Geronimo, one of the dive masters at Discover Manzanillo, told me that in his thousands upon thousands of dives that he's never once been bothered by a shark. And actually, if someone on the beach happens to yell shark because they think they see a shark or there actually is a shark, that the beach will be cleared in minutes. And not only that, all of the scuba divers will gather their gear to get into the water to see the sharks because they're all like, sharks. Yeah.
That'd be wild to see.
I really appreciate that Mariano was fluent in both English and Spanish because it meant that the business part of the dives was effortless and smooth. Not only that, but Geronimo was also fluent in both languages, which meant that I got all of the stories and information that I wanted to hear without the possible mistranslation on my part. But one of my favorite parts is actually getting to practice Spanish, which I got to do a lot on the boat. I got buddied up with this lovely lady called Julia, or Julia. She's French, I hope I'm saying it right. She's also a dive master, and that was really exciting for me because that's one of my goals. Also, she spoke three languages. How cool is that? Another one of the best parts of scuba diving is getting to make friends and meeting all of these new people that also like scuba diving. They're so welcoming, and they even invited me to come hang out with them at the Hoa Bar in Manzanillo, where I got to practice even more Spanish. It was the best. At the bar, there was this light on top of the building that after sunset shined down on the ocean and made the waters glow. And I'm not sure any of the footage actually captured the essence of the glow, but it was beautiful. Believe it. Geronimo also told me that if you want to hear some whale songs while you're diving, then you should go between November and April.
Sounds like a whale.
The water was also extremely cold at the end of April, beginning of May, so just be prepared for that. Bring your own wetsuit. Discover Manzanillo also can provide you a wetsuit, but either way, just be prepared to be a little chilly. One more thing, if you have a dive computer, don't forget it, and it is your responsibility as a diver to remember to log the information after your dives. Don't expect anyone to remember for you. As you can see in some of the footage, these dives don't necessarily have the best visibility. So it's about managing expectations and knowing which seasons to go for better visibility. Geronimo tried to apologize at some point for the visibility quality, but really, like, whose fault is that? No one's. It's no one's fault. I will say that it's not even the worst visibility that I've experienced diving. Originally, I was planning on going diving multiple days, but because of the visibility quality, I opted to work towards another dive certification. That way, when I'm in crystal clear, beautiful water, I don't have to worry about working towards my certification, but rather I can just enjoy the view. Now, if you're like, heck yeah,
I'm ready to party,
check out this video on packing to get you ready for your flight. And thanks for watching. If you like this video, make sure to smash the like button. Don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you next week. Bye. Hi there.
Hello.
Hi.
Hola.
Hi.
Hey, friend.
And thanks for stopping by. Do we like this hand? Do you like this hand? No.
You look so beautiful today.
Really?
No.
I love y'all's smiles. Y'all are so happy.
Uno, tres, tres.